Hi there. You're listening to Spirituality Sideshow, where the weird meets the wonderful. And no, you don't have to stand on your head to understand this.
Unless you'd like to. Like the Joker says, why so serious? Life can be fun even when you're going through shit.
Sheila! Listen on for some weird and wonderful truths. Hit it. Hello and welcome to Spirituality Sideshow. I'm Geetika.
I'm Sheila.
And we are here with this podcast to demystify this big word called spirituality. But let us first introduce ourselves.
I'm Sheila Mathilakath and I'm really glad you guys found us. I'm a Master Spirit Life Coach. I work with people helping them improve their self-worth, increase their self-confidence and become more happy. I'm also a Metaverse of Moment coach and an author of multiple books. One of the main ones being I Complete Me, which I'm proud to announce, was nominated for the Authors Academy.
Wow.
I'm also a retreat leader and I facilitate self-love retreats.
Sheila is an extremely successful celebrity self-love coach. To know more about her qualifications that go like 2 kilometers long, you can log on to SheilaMathilakath.com. We'll put the link in the description. And now me, I'm Geetika. I'm a conscious parenting coach and an early years educator. I have been very fascinated with how our earlier years and our earlier experiences impact the way we deal with life going forward. So I work with parents to help build an environment which is more accepting and loving for children.
Awesome. So now let's get this elephant off the table. Okay. What is spirituality? Now, you know, you and I, we have read a lot of descriptions about what is spirituality and how is spirituality. And I don't know if you saw it, but there was this great war between Javed and
yes.
and Sadhguru. Okay, where Javed Akhtar was debunking actually everything that Sadhguru spoke about, stood for and believes.
Yeah.
Now, actually, it really didn't make any sense to me. But one thing that I really believe is that spirituality has nothing to do with any person, personality, book or religion. It is just a growth into the next level of you, how you up-level. So for me, spirituality is all about personal growth and connecting with that higher self that you have inside of you. It is always said that there is a better version of us. And we have come here into this planet to actually grow into the better version of ourselves, which is called the higher self.
Mm-hmm.
So now it's not a fancy word. It is just an expression for someone who you're better of. Now, a lot of people say the higher self is outside you. I don't know whether it's outside of you, whether it's inside of you. I only know that every day when I wake up, I want to become better than who I was yesterday. And that to me is spirituality.
Right. So, absolutely. Connecting and becoming a better person is something that I think eventually everybody should strive for.
Yes.
And I feel that spirituality over the years that I've worked with you, it has helped me not only better myself, but to much extent get to know myself as well, because I've not been a very self-aware person in the beginning years of my life. And, even to just sit and consider my own thoughts has been a very big experience for me. With the tools that you've taught and what we've learned through our religion at home and things such as meditation, and then you introduced us to journaling, tapping and so on, it's been helping me to become a better person. So I realized that eventually spirituality is just about those tools and how you use them
and what works for you.
Very interesting, Sheila. So you're saying that not every tool of yours work for every of your student?
Every tool I have gone through quite a number of tools myself, learning them and teaching them to others.
Uh-huh.
And I realized that there are some that I don't resonate with at all.
Right.
It's all a matter of your individual choice. See, we all come back with our own values, our own belief systems. And what works for you may not work for me.
Right.
What works for you may be, going to the swimming pool, putting your head deep under the water and staying there for 5 minutes. For me, water is a place where I feel like I'm on the Titanic and I'm going to sink. So it doesn't work for me. So whatever works for you, do that. Whatever works for me, I will use it. I really believe that one of the most important things about these tools, now we're talking about tools, they're not the hammer and
of course.
The processes that we use, they are just used to bring in more clarity into our lives, more focus into our lives, and the ability to handle whatever life throws at you. Because, you know, life is not always a bed of roses. Life is not always
true.
Shots of tequila.
She's got some vinegar sometimes.
Lots of vinegar. Which is amazing. The way the festival of Ugadi that we celebrated.
Correct.
Where there is this concoction that we drink, which is called the Ugadi Pachadi, which is a mixture of the bitter, the sweet, the sour, the salty, and the spicy. And that is what life is.
Sums up well.
Yes. And like Socrates says, unless you're completely aware of yourself, you cannot handle everything that life throws at you. We go into victim modes, blaming others and thinking, why me? Why me? When will I get a break? You know, things like that.
And I think what people try to do with these tools also is, over a period of time, I've realized is that they just want to get somewhere. So I want to reach that inner peace. I want to reach a place. I want to just find inner peace and be the coolest person, the calmest person in the world and get over with it.
Mm-hmm.
But they're mostly disappointed for the only reason that it doesn't seem like it's the destination that matters here at all. Probably your destination is death, I feel. That's where the end. That's where you drop that.
It is said that from the University of Life, the only time you're going to pass out of it is when you have finished with your lessons and you're dead.
Yeah.
So the last day of your...
It's not a very happy checkout.
The last day, the last breath, in fact, that you take is when you finished your schooling here on Earth. But having said that, like you rightly said, it's a journey.
Yeah.
You know, there was a client of mine who said that, you know, it seems to me that I'm always climbing mountains. I just finished climbing one mountain and then another mountain appears. And that exactly, it's such a brilliant analogy for what life is all about.
Right.
They're just mountains to climb, mountains to climb, mountains to climb. And as you climb up the mountain, you reach the peak. From there, enjoy the view. And then you have start your descent downwards. You come to the valley where you rest, relax, rejuvenate, reflect, learn those lessons, and then start climbing again. So the lesson here is not to enjoy the peaks or the valleys. The lesson here is to enjoy the trek.
Correct. I remember once we were having this conversation, you told me that it's only mud that settles.
Yeah.
So then I always remember, because I was yelling at you that, you know, mujhe shaadi karke settle hona, I want to settle after getting married, and I want to settle after having children, I want to settle after having a job. And then you knocked it into me that, you know, only mud is what settles, and that's when you go flatline.
Dust to dust.
Yeah.
Dust will return.
But you know, see, that's what the funny part is I'm realizing, is that when it is so customized, the spirituality is so unique to each individual, why do people go all about, I'm not spiritual, I'm not religious? Okay, religious has a different connotation because it has the labels attached to it, that you're Hindu, Muslim, or you do Havan, or you're Pandit, etc. But because we've been on our fair share of journeys on spirituality, and looks like it's very customized journey to each person, very unique, actually, not customized. Then why do people go all, I'm not spiritual, this is like a label you're giving me, I don't want to be part of this cult. Why this commotion?
When people talk about spirituality and those who believe that they are atheists or agnostics, they always believe that, you know, being spiritual means signing into a certain way of being. People who tell me, you know what, you're spiritual, that means you must be wearing crystals, you have to sit on a pillow and meditate, maybe, you know, all the time you are
what's with the pillow?
Or what is this nonsense about journaling? I always tell them, you know, there is no way that I want to convert someone into my way of thinking or my way of being.
Right.
Everyone reaches their destination in their own time. I want to throw a new thing at you. What if I told you that spirituality is about love? What if I told you that spirituality is about being kind and compassionate? Yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
That is the definition of spirituality. Don't you think that everyone in their own way is spiritual? Because everyone wants to be happy. Everyone wants to be loved. And I know that everyone has a streak of kindness and love within them, which means everyone is spiritual. But like they rightly say, you know, you don't need to label them.
Right. Actually, no, very true. That's so beautiful, no? Because everybody is kind, everybody is compassion, everybody is love. And those are the labels we're very happy with, because that sounds so fancy and good to be looked at with. But spirituality is something which is very ingrained in you. I don't think it's separate from you, because your spirit is not separate from you.
You were the one who brought to me that definition of spiritual. Spirit plus ritual. And that really explains the entire concept.
Right.
Because everyone agrees that there is a soul, there is an atma that we have within us. So if that is a soul, which is unconditional love, there are rituals that you're doing just to reach that place. Now, there was a very beautiful story which I'd heard, and that is about two fish which are swimming in water. Uh-huh. A young fish swimming in the water, and an older fish comes from the opposite direction. And then he tells them, "Hello, boys, how's it going in the water?" And these fish turn to each other and says, "What is water?" You know, the thing is, when you're in the water, you don't know what is water.
What's going on.
So, which is why only if I throw the fish out of water, that the fish will understand what water is. And that's exactly what spirituality is.
True.
We come here with our share of joys and sorrows to understand what love is and move back into unconditional love.
So beautiful. So I was just thinking while you were talking that, Louise used to say that she listens to her something called her inner ding, which is her inner voice. What that does is basically guides her through her life or guides her through her day or in situations that she goes through. So while we were doing our meditation sessions, a lot of sessions with Sheila, and then I started realizing that there is some nudge that I get from within that, okay, tells me that this is what I want to do, this is what I don't want to do, or this might seem right. Of course, a lot of it is based on my own value systems and beliefs. After that, I started reading about how people are the people who are really successful or really focused in their career, you know, who've got things going for them, and how they deal with spirituality. I was watching this Netflix show called The Romantics, which come about Yash Raj Films, and very beautiful documentary, nostalgia kind of sorts. So there, this producer named Aditya Chopra, now he has been the son of a director-producer. So he's been in films through and through. So he talks about how he has been, doing the research on films. Since childhood, he has a notebook where he writes the name of every film, and then he goes about, you know, how much money went into it, how many songs it had, how long was the script, how much money they got in the box office, success, failure, and so on, color coding. So over the years, say 20 years, you're doing some research like that. Of course, your mind starts getting conditioned to pick out, and that decision-making capability becomes your start using your intuition to do that. So Aditya Chopra now uses intuition. So all this research only that has gone, we cannot say that it's come from outside. But I feel that when you are focused on something, some ideas flow, something comes in your mind from your past experience or something that you feel is right. Not every mention has come from a past experience, right?
No, actually, that's a good thing that you spoke about. Now, every invention in this world, no matter what it is, started as an idea, as a dream. There was no past reference for it.
Right.
I know you belong to a generation where to start the computer, you just had to press a start button. Whereas when I started using computers, we had to give a long list of codes. C,
colon, backslash,
and something. And then call the IT department, how do I start the computer? Then the computer would power up. And we didn't have internet, I think, at that point of time. And then came the internet. Even to date, actually, I'm quite amazed at how the fax machines used to
work. Right.
Someone puts in a paper from their office and it comes out in my office.
You do understand it's not the same paper, right?
So everything started as a dream.
Right.
So unless we explore and allow ourselves to dream and allow ourselves, instead of saying that, you know, everything is, of course, everything is within you, but the ability to access it only comes when you're silent and you're looking inwards. But even Javed Akhtar, for that matter, I believe, whether he believes or not, he's a very spiritual person, because he finds his spirituality in his poetry. He finds his spirituality in his songs, in his music.
Yeah.
So that is being spiritual. Like I said, it's all to do with your individuality. The roads may be different, but the destination is the same, and the destination is happiness and love.
True. You know, how in childhood, like, because I am an early years educator, we tell a lot of stories to kids.
Yeah.
And just to, of course, increase their vocabulary, imagination, thinking power. But how, you know, I was reading some psychologists who say is that till the age of 5, kids are living in a world of their own, where it is very hard for them to grasp a lot of things in reality of the world. So they try and make up some connections which are like stories in their mind. Of course, slowly, by 5 years, they try and make sense of the world around them. But they still like to stay in that imagination world. They make drawings that picked so many things, a rainbow and a unicorn flying over a rainbow and so on. But you know, as you approach adulthood, it's almost beaten out of us, that whole imagination, that don't think this. So you know, why do you think that happens?
Everyone acts out of the thoughts that they believe and the things that they have seen and the things that they've heard. So this is the only parameter or a frame of reference that we have to do any kind of action. So our parents have had that with their parents,
right,
their grandparents, and they are following the same thing.
See, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what spirituality is, what spirituality is not, because we are just a tiny speck on a blue planet. Like Carl Sagan, the astronomer, said, the Earth is just a speck in a huge cosmic arena.
So true, so true. I would like to quote Stephen Hawking, that even Milky Way is a tiny drop in the cosmic ocean. So don't we think it's very arrogant of us to believe that we know everything, and everything just originates in our mind and there's nothing else at play?
That's all. To conclude, if you're just a speck on this blue planet, or as Dr. Seuss says in Horton, Here's a Who, we are just the who people on a dandelion carried by a large elephant, then this quote sums it all up. When our invisibility and meaninglessness is a given, we can now joyfully accept rather than angrily and fearfully rage against. We delight and embrace in the full knowledge of our eternal nullity, and delight that right now that blossom looks truly enchanting in the field opposite.
I think that beautifully sums up. Hope we've been able to give you some perspective of what spirituality is, maybe break down the word for you. But that's just the tip of the iceberg. Please keep watching us for our next episode, where we demystify some other truths.